Yeah, no, it's fine. I'm going to let you keep going.
All right,
I got to go and get my dress on for the show. I'll see you in a bit.
Yeah. All right, see ya.
All right. Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. Hey, wasn't Sylvester Stallone great? I thought he was great. I've got to be honest. I'll be honest with you. It's not often I get intimidated by guests, but when they tell me he was coming on, I was like, oh, I'm a bit scared. No, really, because he's a huge movie star, and this is a tiny little crappy show. And he's really nice, and he's been nice to people backstage and handing out money to everyone. He just said he'd give me a back rub. My next guest stars in a fantastic film called The King of Kong. This is a great film. I've seen this film, The King of Kong, A Fistful of Quarters. It's out on DVD on January the 20th. Take a look at this.
I think the energy kind of picked me up. I was feeling kind of like a zombie in the middle of the game. But towards the end, I got, you know, a little bit of a natural rush going from the crowd and the excitement. So that kind of boosted me and put me over the top to complete the game.
This is the highest Donkey Kong score done in public.
Please welcome Steve Wiebe, everybody. Steve Wiebe. Now, Steve.
How you doing?
It's good to see you, and welcome to the show. I'm doing fine, and I'm very glad you're here, because I saw the movie that you're in. It's a documentary, as you know, because you're in it. But I saw the movie, and I thought, we have to have him on the show. The movie is called The King of Kong, A Fistful of Quarters. It's a documentary about the best Donkey Kong players in the world.
That's it.
And I have to be honest with you. When the folks here were saying, you have to watch this movie, I'm like, yeah. To watch a movie about Donkey Kong players. And it's great. I mean, it's really sensational, but you and Billy Mitchell are the two best players really around right now. Yeah. And Billy doesn't come off very well in this movie.
You think?
Yeah. It's an extremely competitive, very aggressive environment, the world of Donkey Kong. By the way, Donkey Kong is also the name of a club in San Francisco.
Oh, it is?
I was there at the weekend.
You gotta go there.
Yeah.
Well, the culture that I never even knew existed. I was just playing in my garage, doing these high scores. And then I went out into this venue called Fun Spot. I had to travel across country.
Right.
New Hampshire.
And New Hampshire? From where do you live?
I live in Redmond, Washington.
That's a long way to go
to
play an arcade.
Long travels.
Yeah.
And my wife wasn't too happy about that.
Yeah. First of all, let me just say, you're married?
Still married.
That's great, though. I mean, it's great to know there are understanding women out there.
There's someone for everybody, I guess. But the funny thing is, I married my high school sweetheart.
You bet you did. Yeah.
I'm very fortunate because in college I had my own Donkey Kong machine.
Right.
And there's no girls coming up to you saying, "Hey, here are you good at Donkey Kong."
Donkey Kong machine.
That doesn't get you very.
Can we
far.
Come over to your place? Because you're a Donkey Kong machine. We actually had a Donkey Kong machine put into the green room today for you to. This is your score today.
Yeah, 693,800.
Yeah. That would have been more, but there was the CBS there, Donkey Kong machine's got a sticky joystick.
A gummy substance was on the.
Yeah, that's CBS.
Yeah.
Gummy substances everywhere you look. So now, who holds the world record right now for the Donkey Kong?
Well, Billy Mitchell came back.
Mitchell.
Yeah.
That
last summer, he went to Mortgage Brokers Convention. It was that retro '80s theme.
Right.
And he played in front of 300 mortgage brokers. And Twin Galaxies is the agency that tracks the records.
That measures the records,
So he performed and beat my score by 1,100 points or something.
Right, you think you can take that, right? You'll get up to it?
I think, if my wife lets me, I'm going to try to sneak out to the garage.
Right.
A couple more times.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, what is happening? I mean, you've become quite famous from this thing as well. Has life changed? Is it a bigger garage you sneak out to?
Yeah. Yeah, we've added on to the garage and make. Life's been great. I never expected this to come out of Donkey Kong.
What do you do for a job when you're not?
I'm a teacher, seventh grade math.
Oh, wow.
So the kids think it's pretty cool.
Yeah, well, it's seventh grade. You're just cusping.
Yeah.
By eighth grade, you are such a dork.
Yeah.
But seventh grade, you're just right. That's great. Do you teach the kids how to play Donkey Kong? I guess that's not in the curriculum for math, is it?
I'm trying to get a class set up where I have a Donkey Kong 101 class and I can teach like an elective, you know? But it's not going to fly, I guess.
No, I don't really think.
The principal didn't want to do it.
No, if they're taking, you know, music and stuff out of schools, they're not going to put in Donkey Kong, you know? Have you always done this? Is it a thing you picked up later, or did you do it when you were a kid, or what?
Yeah, when I was growing up, they called me like a video game addict. I'd come out of the arcades, and my eyes would be all glassed over, and people think, you know, you're stoned on video games.
I was stoned. There were no video games. I was just like...
You were just stoned.
Yeah.
So ever since I was like 9, 10 years old, the first game we had was Pong, of course.
Yeah.
So I moved on to Asteroids and Space Invaders.
Is there any money in this? Do you make any money if you win these games?
No, not really.
Right.
There is the Halo tournaments. There is money for these
newfangled games. Yeah. But you'd have to wear your hat backwards and all that bollocks. You don't want to do that. No. Sure. Hey, listen. Well, listen. Good luck to you. When are you going to have another crack at this record?
I'm going to be in Vegas actually in March for a chance at it.
Okay. Whereabouts?
Trying to think what place. I can't remember where they're
I'm sure they're going to be very happy that you kind of remember, right?
Yeah.
I appear at the MGM Grand. Say that. The MGM? Wow, yeah. They're great.
I think that's it.
Yeah. Listen, Steve, good luck to you. It's really nice to meet you. You come off so well in this movie. It's really terrific. Fair play to you. And thanks for coming on the show. Steve Wiebe, everybody.
Thank you,
guys. We'll be right back. First of all, we've kind of run out of time tonight, so my apologies to Io. We'll have her back out on the show on Friday. So she'll be here on Friday. And you'll know it's Friday because I'll be wearing this tie. I'll wear this tie on Friday as penance. I'll wear it twice. Also, I think I gave you the wrong release date for this movie, The King of Kong, A Fistful of Quarters, the movie about the Donkey Kong Championships, which I've got to tell you, it's amazing. You're like, oh, stop it. I'm telling you. It's great. Anyway, it's January the 29th that's coming out. And that's about it from me. I'd love to keep... Oh, there's the count of time. I gotta go. Good night, everybody. Good night.